Hey, it's Dr. Centeno, and I'd like to talk about the PICL procedure and a case study in severe instability. So the PICL procedure, that stands for percutaneous implantation of the CCJ ligaments. And in this case, I'm implanting a same-day stem cell mix via precise X-ray guided injection. And these are the ligaments that hold the head on. So this is in a patient who had traumatic instability. And so this is a local physical therapist who was involved in the 2009 car crash, diagnosed with CCJ instability, which was severe on DMX. He had a lower cervical disc bulge with pinched nerves, upper cervical facet injuries, and traumatic brain injury. Now, we had treated him for a couple of years, basically focusing on this lower cervical disc bulge, and he got some better. His arm symptoms got better. But it was clear to us that he continued to have a lot of disability related to his upper neck injury. This is the patient's PICL procedure timeline. His first procedure was in February of 2017, second procedure October of 2017, and then his last procedure being reviewed here for progress was June of 2018. Now he's back for a fourth procedure, but this is progress as of these three procedures. And after three PICL procedures and before the fourth, he's reporting about a 65% improvement. He also had his lower cervical spine treated, as I discussed, but those symptoms for him are in his hands and not related to his upper cervical symptoms. And he went from walking a max of about 100 yards now to 4 miles, but still has head injury symptoms. So this is an example of the PICL procedure in this patient, showing the needle going into the left alar transverse ligaments and showing good contrast flow into the alar transverse and accessory ligaments. He had 4 DMX studies during and after these procedures, and the C1, C2 overhang shot, which is this one, is really a measure of alar ligament integrity, and that was the focus of what we were measuring here. So when he started, his left measurement of C1, C2 overhang was 5.6 millimeters, which is a lot. That went down after his first procedure to approximately 3.8 millimeters. And then after two procedures is the left image. And then on the right is after the third procedure. So 4.6 millimeters to 2.3 millimeters. So big change, more than a 50% reduction in that overhang. Going to the other side, to the right, he started with a whopping 7.2 millimeters, which is, again, some of the bigger measurements you see in these patients, that after the procedure went to 4.4 millimeters, and then 4.9 millimeters after two procedures, and then after the third procedure down to 1.2 millimeters. So a dramatic change here of about 80% of overhang. So in summary, the PICL procedure has dramatically improved his function, and objective imaging that measures CCJ instability has supported that conclusion. So thanks so much for watching, and have a great day.